This is the intestines, and this is the uterus, where the fetus grows. During the initial 7 weeks of pregnancy, the fetus is too small to be seen. As pregnancy progresses and the fetus grows, increased pressure on the intestines can lead to digestive problems such as constipation, heartburn, acid reflux, vomiting, nausea, and other symptoms. Share this video with your mother and say, "I love you, Mom." The small and large intestines process food, the liver filters toxins, the stomach breaks down nutrients, the diaphragm facilitates breathing, the lungs oxygenate blood, and the heart pumps it through the body. These vital organs work together to sustain human life. The head and neck have around 42 muscles, including both superficial and deep muscles. The masseter muscle is important for jaw closure, while the sternocleidomastoid muscle is the strongest and responsible for neck movement. The female pelvic muscles are divided into the pelvic floor and pelvic wall muscles. The main openings in the female pelvis are the vagina, urethra, and anus. The vagina is the birth canal and allows for menstrual fluid passage. The urethra carries urine, while the anus eliminates solid waste. Yes, my dear, you are absolutely correct. These balls are the testicles, not the kidneys or another organ, but the testicles are here outside the scrotum and without muscles or skin. The testicles play a vital role in sperm production and testosterone secretion. In essence, this representation provides a glimpse of how our body appears without the presence of skin or muscles.
8 weeks. The dance of life. Week 8 marks the baby's first movements. Nerve cells branch out, forming primitive neural pathways. It's a cosmic dance, connecting the intricate threads of life. Our baby is now the size of a kidney bean.
The human leg consists of 4 bones, femur, patella, tibia, and fibula, and approximately 30 muscles, with the sartorius muscle being the longest. Leg bones undergo constant remodeling, breaking down old tissue and forming new tissue to maintain strength and integrity. Have you ever wondered why uterus looks like this? This uterus resides outside the body, without blood supply. It's preserved in formaldehyde for scientific purposes, aiding medical students in identifying and comprehending human anatomy before interacting with a living body. The human heart tirelessly pumps blood, beating around 60 to 100 times per minute, 4,800 times per hour, and 115,200 times per day. In a year, it beats about 42 million times, and throughout an average 72-year lifespan, it beats around 3 billion times. The heart's dedication to sustaining life is truly remarkable. The human eye is the best camera on the planet. One of the characteristics of the human eye is that it constricts the pupil in bright light to reduce excessive brightness, and expands in low light to allow more light in, and is controlled by the muscles in the iris. Sound waves enter the ear canal and cause the eardrum to vibrate. These vibrations are then transmitted through the 3 ossicles, malleus, incus, and stapes, to the oval window, which leads to the inner ear. In the inner ear, the vibrations are converted into electrical signals that the brain can interpret as sound. Pregnancy is divided into 3 trimesters. The first trimester starts from the beginning of pregnancy until the end of week 13, the second trimester spans from weeks 14 to 27, and the third trimester extends from week 28 until birth. Childbirth is also divided into 3 stages. The first stage is cervical dilatation, the second stage is fetal delivery, and the third stage is the delivery of the placenta. The human body is remarkable and complex. The skin, our largest organ, covers about 1.5 to 2 square meters, 16 to 22 square feet, and hosts trillions of microorganisms. With over 600 muscles, our body enables various movements. We have 206 bones that provide structure, support, and protection. Overall, our body is a marvel of complexity, with skin, muscles, and bones working together. The female pelvis has a unique ability to expand and contract during childbirth. Researchers have found that it retains a memory of this expansion, allowing it to expand further in subsequent births. This showcases the body's ability to adapt and change. Ovulation usually occurs around day 14 of the cycle, where the egg is released from the ovary. If fertilization doesn't occur, menstruation begins around day 28, marking the shedding of the uterine lining. Cycle lengths vary, 21 to 35 days, and ovulation timing varies too. The heart has four valves: mitral, tricuspid, aortic, and pulmonary. They maintain blood flow, ensuring proper circulation and directing blood in the right direction. These valves separate heart chambers, control blood outflow, and play a vital role in maintaining healthy circulation and oxygenating body tissues. The female breast is a vital organ for breastfeeding and infant nurturing. The female breast consists of glands, ducts, and fatty tissue. Regular self-examinations and mammograms are crucial for breast health and early detection of abnormalities, like breast cancer. The prostate is an accessory male reproductive gland located below the bladder, through which the urethra passes. It consists of lobes and zones, and is surrounded by a fibromuscular capsule containing glandular and connective tissue. The pancreas is a vital organ located behind the stomach. It produces enzymes that aid digestion and hormones like insulin that regulate blood sugar levels. Proper pancreatic function is essential for maintaining digestive and metabolic health. The uterus is a hollow, muscular organ in the female pelvic region where fetal development occurs. It is connected to the ovaries, fallopian tubes, and vagina as part of the female reproductive system responsible for menstruation, fertilization, and pregnancy. The thyroid gland is a butterfly-shaped endocrine gland in the neck that produces the hormones triiodothyronine, T3, thyroxine, T4, and calcitonin. These regulate metabolism, growth, and calcium homeostasis. The human skull is composed of 22 bones, including the cranium, 8 bones, and facial bones, 14 bones. Key cranial bones include the frontal, parietal, temporal, and occipital bones. Facial bones include the mandible, maxilla, and zygomatic bones, forming the structure of the face. At 8 weeks, the fetus is around 16 millimeters long, about the size of a raspberry. By next week, it will double in size. The head is starting to uncurl, and the arms are longer and larger than the legs as the upper body grows faster than the lower body.